The purpose of meeting with government representatives and the private sector and discussing with them how can the World Bank Group best support them in boosting trade, enhancing competitiveness, improving the business climate, and fostering innovation and entrepreneurship. In Rwanda, as you may know, I am participating in the World Export Development Forum on the occasion of the 50th anniversary of the ITC. And basically, we have discussed the three aspects that seem to be very, very relevant when talking about small and medium-sized enterprises. The first and having an enabling environment, a good business environment, which in the case of Rwanda, as we all know, tremendous progress has been made, and the country is occupies an excellent spot in the doing business reform, and this relates to all the reforms that the country has embarked upon in the past few years.
Have been involved for some years in the part of the World Bank Group, which is International Finance Corporation, IFC, and they at the moment have a main source of putting significant funding behind SMEs. And the way they do it is not directly. We tried some years ago an experiment of trying to give direct financing to SMEs, but found we were not efficient at doing that. So what we now do is we finance a number of banks in the region, including a number in Rwanda, specifically in some cases for building up their SME business. So we finance small businesses by financing the financial institutions in the region, and that's the main way.
How do you make sure that different government agencies, the sanitary and phytosanitary inspections, the customs agents, the immigration, the security agents, are all coordinated at the border? All of these aspects are absolutely key in fostering regional integration. I think good progress has been done, in particular in the context of the Northern Corridor, but still more work needs to be done to make this a seamless territory where goods can flow freely within the territory.